friends, if this is your first time on my channel, you're most definitely welcome. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for sticking with your girl. If you are not subscribed, please go ahead and click the subscribe button, then hit the notification bell so you know every single time I upload another video. So today I'm going to be talking about the options you have when you graduate college with a low GPA. Let's get into the video. So you hustled. You was going along the lines of C's get degrees, you got that degree, you tried your hardest, and you didn't graduate with the GPA you were hoping for or the GPA that you feel is competitive enough to apply to medical school. So what do? Is all hope lost? The answer is no. There are a couple options and avenues you can do to increase your GPA and to put yourself in a better position to be competitive for medical school. So the two things I'm gonna talk about today are post-bacs and special master programs. And basically, depending on your situation and kind of where you will kind of determine which one you should go for, and I don't think anyone can make that decision for you. You just have to weigh the pros and cons and decide what is best for you as an individual and what you think will be best for your application. So the first thing I'm going to say is a post-bac is basically where you are taking classes after graduating and getting a degree from a four-year institution, and basically you will take classes, and these classes can be taken at the same institution you were at. It could be taken at a community college, it could be taken at another institution, but it is classes you take and grades you get once you've graduated and gotten a degree. There are three different kinds of post-bacs. The first one is a academic enhancer, and basically it's what it sounds like. Basically, if you graduate with a low GPA, it is a post-bac that's kind of geared towards people increasing their GPA, and in those post-bacs you'll be taking a lot more upper division biology, chemistry, physics classes to raise your science GPA. The second one is a career changer. So if you graduated college and maybe you thought you were going to do one thing with your life, but then you had a come to Jesus epiphany where you were like, oh my goodness, I need to go into medicine, and you didn't take any, or maybe you took one or two of the prerequisite classes, a career changer is for you. You will be taking a lot of the prerequisites that are required to get into medical school. And for post-bacs like that, they typically will only accept people who have taken very few, if any at all, pre-med prerequisite classes. They're pretty strict about that, and they're more geared towards people who really have no science background or don't have those classes under their belts. The last one is a DIY, do-it-yourself post-bac. So if you are in a situation where you have an existing career and maybe you need to work and you can't commit to being a student full-time, or there's only select classes that you want to retake, or maybe you just don't have the funds to do a formal post-bac, DIY is perfect for you because it allows you to go at your own pace. You will take it at your own time. So for example, you could work full-time and then maybe take classes at night. And really it allows you to structure post-bac more towards what works for your schedule and what works for you. The other two tend to be more formal and kind of are like more guided programs. Not all of them will fall into that line of structure and guided programs. However, not all of them will fall into that umbrella of structured or guided programs. However, most of them do. A special master's program is a master's program particularly, especially geared towards people who want to apply to medical school and who want to pursue a career in medicine ultimately. Special master's programs, you tend to take classes alongside with medical students, and they're usually attached to a medical school. I'll quickly touch upon this. A master's in public health is great if that's something you want to do and that's something you're passionate about. However, if you compare it to a special master's program, I don't think an MPH holds as much weight as a special master's program if you are doing it for the sake of trying to make your application more competitive and trying to make your grades look more competitive. I think a master's in public health is really, really great if this is something you're passionate about, if you definitely want to incorporate that into your practice at when you become a physician. With that being said, a couple medical schools do have MD MPhD programs, so you could also apply to one of those programs where you're getting two degrees in a certain amount of time as well, instead of doing the MPH then going to get your MD. So now let's talk about the pros and cons of both. I'll start with post-bacs. One of the biggest pros of a post-bac is the classes you take and the grades you earn count towards your undergraduate GPA. And the reason I point this out and say this is because some medical schools, not all, but some medical schools will screen applicants based off of their undergraduate GPA and their MCAT score. So if you are interested in a decent amount of schools that you know screen, and they screen based off of undergrad GPA, that may be something you want to pursue. You may want to pursue a post-bac so that can help you. With that being said, I do think You could possibly call schools and ask them how strict that cutoff is, and ask them if you were to pursue a graduate program or a special master's program, if that would make you eligible to receive a secondary from them if your undergraduate numbers do not meet their cutoffs. The next pro is that some of these post-bac programs are attached or have affiliation with medical schools. And for some programs, what they'll promise you is if you do extremely well in their program, they will guarantee you an interview at that medical school, which is kind of a great thing and a great sense of security. Pending you do well in the post-bac program, right? You're not just guaranteed an interview, but it's kind of great because it allows you to make connections with that medical school ahead of time. It allows you to really get your name out there, allows you to get involved in things at that school, and I think will ultimately help you if you choose to apply to that school. The next pro is the structure that they have. So some post-bacs, especially if they're formal, will offer you MCAT prep as part of like your program. They'll offer you a committee letter when you're applying to medical school. They'll have that pre-med advising services for you. They'll have a lot of resources for you. I'm not promising every post-bac does this, but when you do your research, you'll find that some do, and that can be a really, really great thing to have, especially if you're coming from an undergrad where you didn't have much support, you were pretty lost in the pre-med process, and you need a lot more guidance when it comes to building your application. That is really, really helpful for you. I can't really think of many cons to a post-bac program. The biggest one is they're super, super expensive, and you don't get a degree out of them. Doing a post-bac program, you're not getting any advanced degree. You're just basically paying college tuition money to raise your GPA. For someone who finances is really, really important to them, you may want to consider that of, do I want to spend the same amount of money and get a degree out of it, or do I want to spend that money and just raise my undergraduate GPA? So it really, really comes down to you, your finances, and what works best for you. If you want to know what schools offer post-bac programs, or you're looking for post-bac programs, the AAMC has a catalog where they have all the post-bac programs in the US, and they're categorized by whether they're academic enhancers or career changers. You can filter the search if you want them to be more for people from underserved, underrepresented groups. They have different like filters you could put to find post-bac programs that work for you. If location is important to you, they have that as well. So if you're considering a post-bac program, take a look at that website to get an idea of the kind of post-bac programs they have out there. I will say though, if you don't want to spend post-bac money, I think that's where a do-it-yourself post-bac really comes into play. If money is a issue for you, maybe taking the classes at a community college may be cheaper, and taking it at your own pace may be more affordable for you. The only thing I'll say is you want to see if the medical schools you are interested in accept community college credit. Not all medical schools will accept community college credit, so it's important to do your due diligence and find that out ahead of time, because nothing is worse than investing so much money into taking classes at a community college only to find out most of the schools you want to apply to won't even accept that credit. Check that out first and then make your decision. The biggest pro to a special master's program is you are taking medical school level classes. And that speaks a lot of volume to medical schools, especially if you do well in those classes, because like I said, you'll be taking classes alongside medical students. And if you can excel in those classes, what that tells medical school is that you're able to handle the advanced coursework of medical school, and you are able to do just as well as first year medical students. And that can really, really help your application, and that really, really shows that even if you didn't do well in undergrad, you're now capable of doing well in medical school classes. Like, that's a huge deal. The next pro is you get a master's degree out of it. The money you spend, you know you're getting an advanced degree, unlike the post-bac program where at most they'll probably give you a certificate. A special master's program is really, really good for people who already have a lot of college credits under their belt, especially science college credits, because the truth is, after a certain period, if you have a certain amount of credits, no amount of A's will really help significantly increase your GPA. So for example, if you already have 100 units of maybe 3.0 GPA, 1 year or like 20 units of A's won't really bring that grade up by much. So if you already know you have a lot of science and college credits under your belts, special master's program may be better for you, because at that point, doing a post-bac really won't really move your GPA much, which you want to ask yourself if that matters to you. Like I said before, special master's programs are usually attached to medical schools as well, so you will get that like connection, and I do think they guarantee an interview at that school if you do well in the post-bac program. Some special master's program also, like post-bacs, will offer MCAT support or help you through the application process. The biggest downside of special master's programs is they don't count towards your undergraduate GPA. So if you are looking at schools that really do screen applicants and your undergrad GPA and increasing that is really important to you, a special master's program won't do that. On your medical school application, it will have the GPA you earned in college. So if it was a 2.9, if it was a 3.0, if it was a 2.85, that's still gonna show up on your application. And then your master GPA is gonna be a whole different subsection. So they won't combine and they won't like average them out. So it's gonna be your undergrad GPA and then your graduate GPA. And ultimately you have to make that decision if that's okay for you. But like I said, medical schools tend to recognize special master's programs, and they know that in special master's programs, you are taking classes with med students. So chances are, if you're doing well in that program, you are probably academically prepared for medical school. I hope this video was helpful in informing you guys of the options you have after graduating, of ways to make your application more competitive from the academic side. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video with a friend, share this video in a group chat, share this video with someone who you think it will help, and I will see you guys in another video.